I'm Justin. I'm the Veterans Agent for the Town of Northborough and the Central Mass Veterans Service District. I'd like to welcome you today to the dedication ceremony for the Purple Heart signs. Brief history, I'd like to recognize the Fire Department, Police Department, the Northborough Honor Guard, Representative Craig Water, Board of Representative Harold Hunter, the Board of Select Chair Jason Perrell, and I cannot remember your last name, Leslie, right? You can. And also our Gold Star mother, Leslie Arsenal, and her husband Dan, work here. We have a Purple Heart winner, Denny Drury, who's been a fixture here in Northborough and in Westborough as a select member, and various others throughout the town. Are there any other Purple Heart recipients in the audience today? Well, I'd like to thank Denny for his service to our country, this time specifically on his tenth today, and any other Purple Heart recipient that we've had, we have residing here in Northborough. So the history of the Purple Heart goes back to George Washington. It was the first medal that was authorized for wounded members of the Continental Army, and it was reconstituted in the 1900s, so the early 20th century, as an award for, it used to be an award for valor, and now it is an award to get wounded in combat. So you have to physically receive a wound due to enemy action of some sort, right, to be awarded the Purple Heart. And in 2013, the Military Order of the Purple Heart designated the town of Northborough as a Purple Heart town, creating another stop on the nationwide Purple Heart Trail. The Purple Heart Trail is a series of towns that have recognized recipients of the Purple Heart in order to recognize them for their service. And Northborough joined that illustrious group now. I'm honored to finally be able to post these signs. There will be 8 signs posted through the entrances of the town of Northborough on the main routes. So you may see them as you drive in and out of town.
Company, the Arsenals, and everyone else here, Denny, the other Purple Heart recipients, Representative Burgoyne, Representative Gregoire, and the members of the board. And actually, I would ask the members of the board to step up as well with John. I want to congratulate the town, and Justin, and all of the veterans organizations and the support organizations, and the families, the Ellsworths and the McAfees, who have held up the pride of this town for so many years. And I would often say, of all the towns I represented in my 26 years in the House, there was always such a tremendous turnout on Memorial Day and Veterans Day's events in this town. And of course, the American Legion Honor Guard was always a central part of that, a central part of this community. And for our first responders, police and fire, to always be there at events like this, that it just was always, someone who served both in Iraq and Afghanistan multiple times, who always felt like coming home when I came to Northborough. And sharing, especially with the events of recent times, it's a pleasure to be here again, since we didn't have the opportunity with the pandemic of the last year. But just let me congratulate the town for stepping up and becoming a Purple Heart town and recognizing and continuing to recognize the sacrifice of those service members with us and gone. And when I was closing my offices down, both my State House office and my district office, I found a box I packed away when I got back from my last deployment in 2015. I forgot, in the rush of things, when you get home to see family and friends, I had packed this box away. So I would ask the members of the Board of Selectmen and the town administrator and Dan and Leslie to step up here, please. I don't want to really impose on this very honored ceremony, but this was something I didn't have the opportunity to do prior to leaving. So, 2015, I had the honor of having this flag fall at Kandahar Airfield in southern Afghanistan. Task Force 2010, United States Forces Afghanistan. In honor of the town, in honor of the people of the town of Northborough, this certificate of authenticity is to verify that the flag was flown at Kandahar Airfield, Task Force 2010 office in Kandahar, Afghanistan, while in support of Operations Freedom Sentinel. The soldiers and civilians of this detachment dedicate this flag in honor of the people of Northborough, owned by Harold Naughton. As a major then, a lieutenant colonel now, by the way, this evening. And Jason Riley, my dear friend, colonel of the United States Army. And Leslie and Dan, I could ask you to accept this on behalf of the people of the town of Northborough. I'm sorry it's so late, but here it is. Still means as much as it did at the time. Okay, thank you for letting me be a little part of this. Take care.
Thank you, Mr. Martin.
So any time that you see a Purple Heart sign, know that that town has taken steps to become recognized as a supporter of those who were wounded in combat. I would say that it is the closest you can come to giving the ultimate sacrifice, getting wounded in combat. Thank you very much for being here today. And keep in mind, your veterans, they serve at the will of the government, and they serve with the best interests of the townsfolk that they know at back home. So anytime you see a Purple Heart sign, just remember, you know, there's people out there that are doing things that you don't know about right now to keep you safe. And when they come home, yeah, it's our duty as civilians to recognize them for their sacrifices and their service. So thank you very much for coming today. This concludes the ceremony dedicated to the Pearl Order of the Purple Heart.